Hi guys, it's Harrison. Today is Monday, July 17th, 2017. I'm here with my new wagon. It's a 1996 Buick Roadmaster Estate Wagon in LDM. That's Light Driftwood Metallic. This is my second wagon, and I figured I'd just post a video for you guys. As you can see, the body's in a lot better shape on this one. No quarter panel rest. Show you guys the back of it. Had this car for, I don't know, 2 weeks. Finally got around to waxing it. It has a tow package, as you can see here. Thought I'd show you that first. And a trailer brake, which I don't need to tow, but if I do, I'd be all ready to go. So, I guess we'll go ahead and start up, show you everything on it. The interior is slightly different than my other one. Door panels are a little different. I guess I'd start with going over the qualities. It has these door pulls here, which I like. It doesn't have a handle here like my 93 did. Also, these controls are a little different. I personally think the qualities are less in the later ones. All the tree clips or whatever you call them are broken. That's the one thing I don't like about this is the door panels. The dash design I do like. I do wish it had a tach, but you can access that through diagnostic mode. I'll show you later how to do that. Seats are in good shape. All of them are in really good shape, except for the drivers, so I'm gonna get that replaced. So I'm asking why I bought this car. It was because the owner was asking good price for it, and I really liked the shape this one was in terms of, you know, body and stuff. And he took good care of it, so I wound up selling my 93 to a guy who built them in Arlington, Texas back in the factory in the 1990s, so I thought that was pretty cool. Anyway, here you go. Automatic climate control. Also, 1 year only option was this weird cup holder design. All the Buicks had that in 96. I don't know why. I like the older style better. It's a little different. The dash is different. 94, they redid it. Well, anyways, also you got a driver's side airbag, or a passenger side airbag. Mine only had a driver in my 93. Same auto-dimming rearview mirror. Also in this one, it was an option. You have the grab handles, which I kind of like. I guess I'll pop the hood. LT1 tow pack, so you got the mechanical fan there. My L05 was just a regular one, wasn't a tow pack. The 94 or 96 cars only had this if they were tow pack. Picks up a lot better than my other one did. The L05, I'll say, was a good engine, but this one is a big improvement, and they improved it in a lot of ways that I wish, you know, the L05 was. That's why I liked this car, because all the things I didn't like about my 93 were fixed on this one. Also, one thing I like is these mirrors. My 93 had these really weird looking smaller mirrors. Some people like those. I like these mirrors better. They're a lot bigger. You can see better.
and they're mounted here like they should be, not in the door. And also these fold in too. So if you're in a parking spot and you're next to people who, you know, are close parked close to you, you know, you can fold in the mirrors so they don't get hit. These are 15-inch magnesium alloy wheels, I believe. They're off of Buick Riviera. The previous owner said he went to all junkyards everywhere to find these wheels. It took him a year or so to find them. I think they look pretty good. Has the same tires my other one did. Hankook Optimos H724s. The size is 225/75R15. They stopped making Uniroyal Tiger Paws in this size, which is what my 93 originally had. This car did too. But you know, the Hankook Optimos are pretty good. Back. Go ahead and rev it up for you guys. It has that loud mechanical fan, so that's why it makes all that noise when I rev it. You'll see in a minute. That's a Cali converter rattling like that. Thought I didn't do a very good job of putting it in. Our lights on. Show you the turn signals too. I'm just kind of doing this review, however, just to show you guys everything. The lights are in a lot better shape than my other one. I love the tinted windows too on this car. A lot nicer. Now look at that awesome tow hitch. Apparently they don't make these anymore to fit the B-bodies. I don't know if that's true or not, but that's what someone told me, so I guess I'm lucky to have one. Also, 95, they moved the state wagon badge to here, and then it only said Roadmaster. The reason why they did this was the Roadmaster Limited said Limited here. This one isn't a Limited. The only thing, you know, differentiating from a Limited is the lack of a lumbar and heated seat. This one has all the other options. Has every other option that my 93 did, with addition to the tow package, which is really nice because I get that limited slip differential. The Vista roof. I love how the light reflects off of it. It matches the tinted windows. There's a few things I need to fix on it, but it's been a good car so far. Just like my old one. Great cars. Also the Sungate windshield. My windshield cracked on my 93, so I got one replaced by a safety light. They don't make these Sungate windshields anymore, I don't think, to fit this car. So I had to get a, you know, different one. Sungates, I like them because they're tinted and they reflect the sun really nicely. Let's see if I can get it to reflect there. They kind of like that bluish color. It really blends well with the tinted windows. Also, this one retains all of the rubber trim, which none of these have this. At least some of them do, but most of the ones I see don't. It's really hard to find these with all the rubber trim on them. Bought from Silveria, Pontiac, and Buick, Healdsburg. It's a town in NorCal, I think. My other one came from NorCal as well. Let's pull out the NorCal car. Main thing I want to show you first. I still have to unlock the car. I wanted to show you that rust, but as for now, this is the interior. Steering wheel is a little different. I like the steering wheel a little more. Well, the only thing I miss is having a tach. I have the tachometer there. It's kind of a pain to get to it, but you know, if I'm in overdrive or whatever on a hill, it's nice to have, at least.
This is something interesting. It's a aftermarket radio out of an Oldsmobile, probably a Bravada or an Aurora or something of the late 90s, early 2000s. Fits in there, has theft lock. That was a later thing. And this is the same, you know, size, double DIN. My other one was a 1.5 DIN with odd GM sizing. So I guess we'll go ahead and show you the rest of the car. I really love these cars. They're nice. They don't make them this way anymore. It's too bad, really. I apologize, my video skills aren't the best. Uh-oh. Could have been bad. And there's rust up there, just like my other one, so I made a few hundred bucks on the deal, so I'm gonna pay that, get that fixed. Just out of the door, pretty similar to the front. Got your door pulls here. I mean, this one's in better shape than the other one because it's not used as much, but I feel like they kind of cheaped out in the later years on these cars. The funny thing is, the Caprices and the Impala, they still have the older door design. For some reason, they redid it for the Buick, I guess, to make it look different. You can see you got your lights here, coat hooks, these handles, which are really nice. My other one didn't have that. My friends like that because, you know, I guess apparently they don't agree with my driving all the time. Just out of the dash. Looks nice. Like, I like this newer dash. I don't like the newer door panels. And I don't like how it just has this speedometer. I might swap in a Camaro cluster. Some people have done that. I don't know how, but it'd be a fun project if I could figure out how. Vista roof, of course, with the sunshades. As you can see, I got plenty of leg room. One thing I do like about the later wagons of this body style is they really improved the rear seat design. It's a lot more comfortable than my other one. My other one was still comfortable, but they redid this part here. Like, they made it a little more firmer and made it stick out more, so larger people would be more comfortable. See this thing here, they improved that by having it integrated into the seat. On my other one, it was behind the seat, the firewall there, so it always got stuck in there. But yeah, here's the back seat. Give you a shot of it real quick. I'm going to show you the third row here. Opens both ways like my other one. I need to still detail the interior. I did the seats, I just need to vacuum it. If you guys are wondering what it's like to sit back here, I don't think I showed you on my other video, my 93. But my 93 had the same thing. I'm in a church parking lot just so I can film this. Obviously those things open. Also, this thing here is pretty cool. The previous owner, every week or every day, he drove it to LA and back. And whenever something broke, he fixed it that weekend. So obviously, he put a lot of money into this car. And there's a mountain load of paperwork that came with it, documenting all the services. So it's good knowing that the previous owner took care of the car. Also, the owner before that, he bought it used, pre-owned in the late 90s, early 2000s at a Buick dealer. And he serviced it at that Buick dealer for about 10-15 years, so it's good to know that they take care of their cars. Now, I don't know who had it first, but I do know that they traded into the dealer until like the late 90s. Now, the nice thing about my 96, unlike my 93, is that it's OBD2. So I don't have to buy an expensive OBD1 scan tool or use a little pen to read the codes flashing. It's a lot harder. The nice thing about OBD2 is you just plug this in, and it works. It tells you the trouble codes and you can clear them if you have to. I don't recommend doing that if you want to pass emissions inspection. See, Pathfinder 98, copyright 1998. So I don't know if this works on newer cars, but it works on older cars, and I'm happy about that. Spare tires back here. It's a full-size spare, believe it or not. I don't want to take this off and put it back on. It's a pain in the butt. Also, these clip-on cup holders, I clipped them on the headrest there. They work pretty good. I have little cup holders back here, which is nice, but they don't have them in the middle. Just to release the seats on these cars, you just pull them here, and there you go. Also, the new owner put in a, previous owner put in a starter right before I bought it because the starter was going bad. Cargo cover? Shock down the side here. Apologize if I'm taking forever, I just want to film everything. One thing I love is, other than the two spots on the roof, there is no rust on this thing. So I could get this, you know, get those things fixed at a good body shop I know, and, you know, it'd be a rust-free car. Something I'm not used to. One reason why I bought this was the body was in good shape. It was taken care of a little better than my other one. This has 248,000 miles, so it has more miles, but I liked that it was taken care of, and I liked the shape the body was in compared to my other one. My other one had a lot of issues, and my other one needed a lot of work just to pass smog, so I'm glad I got rid of it. The door here. Also, I failed to mention Concert Sound 2 audio. Ashtray. Also, this is from the for sale sign. I had to clean that up. One cool thing, very 90s, but the owner before the recent one, second owner, I believe, he put in a car phone. So it had a satellite here for the cellular phone, and it had mounts here. Now, he got rid of those before he sold it to the other guy. It would have been cool to have those, but oh well. Glove box. It's kind of small in this car, but, you know, has enough shelves for your stuff. The reason why I think they made it smaller was they wanted to fit in the airbag, and they didn't know how to do that. So I guess they redesigned the whole dash as a result. There you go. Buick Premium American Motor Cars. Very old school. This was bought at a Silveria Pontiac Buick GMC. It's in NorCal. Now, this owner's manual is not in color. I wish it was, but it's not. There's a really weird drawing of a Buick LeSabre. It's, I think, a Pontiac Bonneville that they photoshopped with wheel covers and stuff to look like a LeSabre. It's just an owner's manual, so obviously they want to have all the cars have the same pictures. It's easier. You know, you guys have seen owner's manual before from GM, I assume, so you know what that looks like. But yeah, this is a nice car. Only issue I had was the air pump getting it to pass smog, so I got that fixed. It was cheap. That's kind of an issue. It's a little rough between 39 and 40 miles an hour. The owner said he had to replace one of the distributor cables, so just in that little spot. So it probably needs new spark plugs and new distributor cables because it's been a while. The Opti Spark was replaced recently, so that's why I got it. And also the transmission shifts good, but it was built, rebuilt a year ago. So it's kind of nice having a new transmission because the one on my 93 was kind of old and it was starting to slip and stuff. That was because it was an older car, but you know, it'd be nice to get something with a newer transmission. I really like these cars. I don't know how to describe why I like them so much. I guess because they're the last of the big rear-wheel drive cars, you know. And this one is a 96, which back when I was looking at these, my dream wagon was to find a 1996 Topac in Light Driftwood Metallic, and here I found one, so I'm really happy about that. So look how the keys look. This one has the passkey 2, I believe. Corvette had passkey 1 back in the 80s, but it's pretty much like an immobilizer chip. All cars that have them in the key itself. Basically, if someone tries to stick in a key that was fake or a screwdriver or something, the ignition system will be disabled if it doesn't find that chip. So it's a theft deterrent system that sometimes stops working completely, so you can't use your car at all.
I waxed this car and looks like it came out good. I'm impressed with it.
As you can see, the collector's edition hood ornament, that was 1996 only, because it was the last year they were making them. They were planning to stop making them in 95. They're going to start making them in 96 because of that. The funny thing was, they made them all the way to December of 96. Now, that was the Caprice and the SS. I don't know if they made the Buicks until then. Most 96 Buicks I come across were made early in January, or February of 96. This one's a real early 96. It was made in December of 95. I was born December of 98, so I'm a few years newer than it, but, you know. Let's see, December of 96 is when they stopped making them, so this was exactly a year before they stopped making them, which I think is really cool. Got a shot of it.
Alright guys, well thanks for watching. I'm gonna make some more videos of this car, like a test drive and maybe some updates here and there. I do have a goodbye video, kind of Sandy that I made in a parking lot somewhere else that I'll post for you guys. Sandy, for those of you who don't know, is my 93 wagon. This is Sandra, my 96. I'll make a goodbye video of my 93 though, which I did. So I'll be posting that, and I'll have a test drive. I'm in Costa Mesa right now, so I'm debating to film it there, or I might go to Long Beach and film it, or maybe Huntington Beach or something. There's some nice areas in SoCal here to film a test drive. Just gotta find a nice one. So yeah, just please leave a comment, please subscribe, please like the video, and if you have any friends who like cars or whatever, please go ahead and show this video to them. Thanks for your time. See you later.